Thus they say we will pass from the earth and its toilings, only to be remembered by what we have done. What would you be remembered for? Today I stand to talk about a rare gem. He had a vision, made it his mission, and gave in his all to the actualization of his visions. Wondering who deserves these carefully selected and properly constructed grammatical appraisers, I am talking about the Ozimba One of Africa, Tony Gray.
The more we are together, the happier we shall be. Ozimba!
A man who reigned in the 70s, 80s and beyond, expressing music in a unique form in a time when music wasn't as lucrative as today. Tell me who in the 70s, 80s did not dance or sing along to the tune of Come Back Love, released in 1975, to mention but a few. A man who is regarded as one of few who made the entertainment industry work in Warri and beyond.
A man that has contributed immensely musically to the success of entertainment in the Niger Delta, in Nigeria, and in Africa. As the president of Ozimba, Ozimba One of Africa.
He showed respect for all. That tells you that there's a man that stood for that adage which says respect is reciprocal. And set a kind of pace for the younger generation in the industry, music industry. While I was quite young, he was the kind of man that I looked up to, even in my school days. I sneaked from school then to attend his functions, paid into the halls to watch his functions. And one thing that interested me at that time was the cream of brassmen, lover of trumpet, anything that has to do with brass. You see, trumpet, baritone, euphonium, saxophone, all those set of wind instruments.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you don't know Tony Gray, aka Ozimba One of Africa, if you don't know this man, that is to say you are not a fan of the music industry in Niger Delta, in Nigeria as a whole, and in Africa as a whole, because Tony Gray is a legend and is a father to all and in the music industry.
Tony Gray is one person I live up to. I was very small when I heard about, I've been hearing about Tony Gray. When I met him as a man, as a boss, I really appreciated it. He inspired me so much in the entertainment world. I want to live a life like him.
One of the forerunners of nightlife in Warri City, who single-handedly brought Performing Musicians Association of Nigeria to Delta State.
My dad brought P-Man, Performing Musicians Association, to Bendel State.
Okay.
He, himself and Sir Victor Waifo.
He's number 11 among the millions. P-Man is the largest music black organization in the world. And Tony Gray is number 11. He brought P-Man to Delta State. And so he's our legend, he's our stakeholder, he's our elder statesman. Of course, he's one of our mayor in terms of music.
The man who brought in P-Man into Delta State is the legend. And of course, he has done a lot. Today, you can find that a lot of stars have come out of Warri. Warri has produced lots of stars. So today, I'm sure very many of us have been affected by what by the Union Performing Musicians Association of Nigeria.
A man that proved you don't have to be in Lagos to be a prominent Nigerian musician. What a man, a great father, husband, and musical legend. But what actually went wrong?
of his guitarists. I played guitar with him before. He's a good man. I learned a lot from him, and today I'm happy to be here to give him the last respect.
We're going to really, really miss him, but we'll celebrate a life of impact. Yeah.
Call him the boss, because he taught me how to sing many, many years ago when I was little.
I played with Tony Gray for 13 good years.
He's a perfect dad to everyone.
Tony is like a godfather to every one of us. I mean, he inspired a lot of us growing up, you know. So if you know who Ozimba is, you know that he has touched everyone's life growing up as a musician.
That's such his life. We miss him so much.
If you want me to describe him, I will not live here, you know, but I just want to say in one word, my dad is a legend. You know, he's a legend in music, a legend in wisdom, a legend in so many ways, and like they say, he lives on.
Tony Gray is a humble man. He's not proud. He plays with everybody, big and small, old and young. So I learned humility from him. It's good to be humble. No matter your level in life, be humble.
Tony Gray is an icon. I grew up in the industry to meet legends like them. He's a father. They were the senior ones that paved the way for young acts like us. They created that platform. They made Wari to enjoy entertainment right from the days. When I mean the days. As a matter of fact, my father made me to enjoy his music, and you just need to give him respect. He's a legend. He's a legend.
You must have seen the cream of personalities that attended this funeral of today. We've been gathered all day in respect of a great legend. The legend we're talking about is the Ozimba of Africa. Particularly, well, let me be specific. I'm talking about the music legend, Tony Gray, who has passed on but lives on. By what you have seen today, eyes have witnessed today, is a man who lived a good life, worth emulating.
He's the Ozimba one, he's the lion, so we're here to pay the last respect to him.
Tony Gray was my father in the music industry. He was the one that told me to be original. You know, formerly I was doing copyright music, and he met me somewhere, Ludo Night Club. He said, "What's your name?" I said, "Oh, Fresh." He said, "Please, be original, be original." That was the word too. So today I'm celebrating him because he gave me a name, he gave me a platform. Be original.
Stay with me as I bring to you life and death of Tony Gray. I am Harrington's Courage Power. Stay connected via our social media platforms displaying on your screen.